Hi, I'm Doug Woodward, sitting in for Kevin Clarkson, who's out of town this week. And we are really honored and pleased for the first time to have a noted author, researcher, syndicated radio host, Paul McGuire, in the studio here at Prophecy in the News. Paul, welcome to Oklahoma. Welcome to Prophecy in the News.
Doug, great to be here, and it's an honor to be here for the first time.
Yeah, well, we're really pleased that you could make it. And but we wanted to talk just for a few minutes in this daily update about what's going on in Jerusalem. It is scary there, and there have been numerous attacks, individuals killed, knifed, and so forth. What do you think is behind all of the unrest and really the terror that's going on in the streets of Jerusalem?
Well, I think what we're seeing is an escalation of the plan for a two-state solution. And I would just say right up front, I think that a two-state solution may play out a lot sooner than people realize. In other words, I think we could wake up one morning and see a UN resolution or an emergency vote that's a crisis would happen mm-hmm. first. And then in response to a crisis, we have a two-state solution because we have the UN heavily driving mm-hmm. for a two-state solution. We have the international community, and of course, we have the Islamic States. So this chaos, this violence in Israel or against Israel is orchestrated to put pressure on the international community to bring about a two-state solution.
Yeah. Well, it's interesting in the bit of reading I've done on it that you have a lot of challenges coming up against the leaders, both Netanyahu as well as Abbas. That's the head of the Palestinians. What appears to be happening is that they are both being attacked by their respective constituencies for not being strong enough. What kind of additional instability does it really bring into the situation that you have Netanyahu, that his constituents, the Jews are saying, the Israelis are saying, you know, you're not doing enough to keep us secure. You've got a boss that basically has recently made this blockbuster announcement at the UN that the Palestinians will no longer go along with the Oslo Accords. You know, how does that really influence or precipitate additional violence in the situation?
Well, you have two leaders, Abbas and Netanyahu, responding to the people that put them in office, so to speak, and pressuring them to take a stand strong. But around that, you have the Russian military invasion, if you will, of Syria. You have the U.S. Lack of inspection of Iran's nuclear production facilities. Mm-hmm. And then you have all kinds of instability in that region. ISIS, you have the explosive situation in Iraq, and all of this surrounds Israel. So if you look at it like from a satellite point of view, you see these explosive situations all around the nation of Israel. I believe that they are deliberately orchestrated, and I think that the UN has a very clear agenda to bring about a two-state solution. But they can't bring in the two-state solution unless they first have a crisis. When I was in Jerusalem a year ago, walking around the old city, mm-hmm. I couldn't help but notice very conspicuously all these UN vehicles. And it was almost like a foreshadowing that one day, soon, Israel or Jerusalem will be administered or governed by some kind of UN force.
Mm. It one of the things that I've noticed as well is that it seems that many of the Jews, the shopkeepers in the streets of Jerusalem, they're very fearful of what's happening. I'm wondering, it looks like that they're even saying, well, maybe the two-state solution is the right thing to sort of sequester the two groups, keep them apart. Now, how dangerous is that? That even the Israelis are, the shopkeepers are having these feelings.
Well, it's extremely dangerous, and this idea, which goes against the Bible, that you can give away the land that God has given His people for peace, always ends in disaster. Mm. Whenever Israel has given away land for peace, disaster has followed, and so I remember, by the grace of God, having a private meeting with the former prime minister of Israel Ehud Olmert a number of years ago. And we talked person to person like we're talking now. And I specifically asked him about giving away land for peace and Bible prophecy. And he assured me privately, I will never give away land for peace. But then, shortly afterwards, he read a book that I wrote, Are You Ready?, which again warned from Scripture about not giving away land for peace. But after this Lebanon-Israeli conflict back then, what did he do? Is he opened up certain territories, right, which invited more disaster.
Yeah. Well, it's the times, there's so much violence in Jerusalem, and it is very worrisome, and we certainly need to be in prayer for the peace of Jerusalem, and we would just remind you, our viewers, keep praying for the Israelis and for the Palestinians.
Amen.
And we need to keep lifting them up, because it is a frightening time. That's all the time we have for this daily update. Thanks, Paul, for being with us.
Thank you.
We'll do another one here for tomorrow. Thank you.